Hi, this is Dr. DeBusque. The most advanced level of insect evolution are neopterous wings with holometabolous or complete metamorphosis. Endopterygota is composed of insects with that description. They have a wingless larval stage that looks different from the adult. Unlike hemimetabolous development, the larvae and the adult will eat different types of food. The pupal stage is a non-feeding stage. The insect order Neuroptera, or netwing insects, include lacewings, mantid flies, antlions, and their relatives. Adult Neuropterans have four membranous wings, all about the same size with many veins. The wings are often held roof-like over their body. They have chewing mouthparts and undergo complete metamorphosis. The larvae of most families are predators, eating aphids and other pests. Some are used for biological control. Antlions bury themselves completely out of sight and ambush prey from pits in the soil. Beetles are in the order Coleoptera, the largest order of insects with about 40% of all known insects. Their front pair of wings are hardened into wing cases, Elytra, distinguishing them from most other insects. It forms a protective cover for hind wings when the insect is not in flight. They are holometabolous, and the larvae are referred to as grubs. Beetles have chewing mouthparts, and some are predators like ladybug adults and larvae, while others feed on plants and can be major plant pests, like the Colorado potato beetle. Flies are insects with a pair of functional wings for flight and vestigial hind wings called halteres for balance. They are classified into the order Diptera, derived from the Greek meaning two wings. They contain an estimated 1 million species and include the familiar housefly, horsefly, cranefly, lovebug, and mosquito. Flies have a mobile head and a pair of large compound eyes. The mouthparts are designed for piercing and sucking, such as mosquitoes, black flies, and robber flies, or for cutting and sponging in other groups. The life cycle of flies consists of eggs, larva, most are maggots, pupa, and the adult. Flies undergo complete metamorphosis. The eggs are laid on the larval food source, and the larvae, which lack true limbs, develop in a protected environment, often inside their food source. The pupa, in higher dipterans, is a tough capsule from which the adult emerges when ready to do so. The source of nutrition for adult flies is liquefied food, including nectar. Many are important pollinators, while others, like mosquitoes, are vectors for disease. Fleas are small flightless insects that form the order Siphonoptera. As external parasites of mammals and birds, they live by consuming blood of their hosts. Bodies flattened sideways enable them to move through their host's fur or feathers. Strong claws prevent them from being dislodged. They lack wings and have mouthparts for piercing skin and sucking blood, and hind legs for jumping, saltatorial legs. Fleas are holometabolous, and only adults feed on blood, with the larva feeding on organic matter. The Oriental rat flea is a plague vector. The bubonic plague was the most common form of the Black Death. The mortality was close to 100%. Even today, there is no treatment. Symptoms are high fever and skin turning deep shades of purple due to disseminated intravascular coagulation. Yes, all from a flea bite. Lepidoptera is the second largest order of insects behind Coleoptera. Lepidopterans are holometabolous and larvae are known as caterpillars. While it appears that caterpillars have many legs, there are only three true pair and 2 to 8 pairs of fleshy prolegs. Most caterpillars are herbivorous with chewing mouthparts, and many can cause substantial damage to crops, trees, and ornamental plants. Some caterpillars can sting because they are covered with urticating hairs, as in this Puss caterpillar. Adult leps are well known for their scaled wings. The adult butterflies and moths feed by a siphoning tube, a proboscis that is coiled for storage. There are a few important differences between moths and butterflies. Moths have antennae that taper to a point and are thick-bodied with wings that lay against the abdomen at rest. you are likely to see more moths at night flying around. Butterflies tend to be out during the day, and their tiny are end in a club with a more delicate body and wings held upright or out to the side at rest. Hymenopterans are social insects that are specialized for their particular niche. They are holometabolous and have chewing mouthparts. Some, like bees, have modifications where their mouths are shaped like a tongue and lap nectar from flowers. They have four wings that are joined together, fore and hind wing, by tiny hooks called hamuli. Some wasps are herbivores and form galls. Others are tiny and are parasites of other insects. Many bees and wasps are important pollinators of plants. As the bee lands on a flower to suck its sweet nectar for food, it catches pollen on its body. When it lands on another flower, this pollen will fall off, thereby fertilizing the flower. Ants are common pests around homes. Those of you in southeastern U.S. are familiar with fire ants. These were accidentally introduced into the U.S. in the 1930s and have been quite successful. An interesting fact about hymenopterans is that females develop from fertilized eggs and males develop from unfertilized eggs. In review, the insect orders are grouped according to whether or not they are ametabolous, hemimetabolous, or holometabolous. You'll also see that the insect orders are grouped according to the absence or presence of wings and whether or not the wing has a flexon, pterygote, paleopterus, or neopterus. The orders are also grouped according to how the wings develop. If the wings develop from structures on the outside of the body, the insect is called an exoskeleton. If wings develop from internal wing pads, the insect is called an endoskeleton. Be sure you know which orders go with each classification.